Claude Code is now GA, and today I'm going to build a document generation application using the Box API. I'm Alex Novotny, Senior Developer Advocate here at Box. Let's get started. If you aren't familiar, Claude Code is Anthropic's CLI-based code generation tool. It allows you to generate code for a new repository or edit code within an existing repository. If you want more information on all of the features and functionality of Claude Code, make sure to check out the documentation at docs.anthropic.com. I have already installed and configured Claude Code on my machine, and if you need more information on that, make sure to check out their website. For the demonstration today, we're going to be creating a simple document generation tool using Box DocGen. If you aren't familiar, Box DocGen is our native document generation platform. It allows you to take an input from third-party systems and create a document that is stored securely in Box. In Box, I have already set up a DocGen template. I have also set up a Box custom application. If you need more information on setting up those pieces, make sure to check out our developer documentation at developer.box.com. So let's assume that I know very little about the Box API. That is where Claude Code comes in. It allows me to spin up an application in minutes when it could have taken much longer or significantly more resources. For this demo, I'm going to use VS Code, but you could also use another IDE or simply a terminal window. As you can see, I have a blank folder opened. The first thing we need to do is run Claude. This will open a chat interface. Then we should run /init. And you should do this whether it is a new repository or an existing one. Most times when you send in a prompt to Claude, it will also prompt back asking you to confirm whether or not it can complete certain actions. In this case, I do want it to create this file. So what that command just did was two things. One, it created a file that we can't see, a hidden file, that provides allow and deny permissions. For example, if I want it to access or not access certain websites on the internet. It also creates a claude.md file. The claude.md file is very important. This provides context to Claude Code as it's creating your application. Now, thinking about the typical application development lifecycle, one of the first things that you do is create a list of requirements. And that's exactly what we're going to do here. We are going to ask Claude to create a PRD, or product requirements document. This will list out everything I want my application to and not to do. I've also included links or pointed it to specific code samples or documentation that exists on the internet that it can utilize to create the PRD. I have already written this prompt, so let me copy paste it in and we can send it off and it will create the PRD. I should note that this can take some time. It needs to go out and research the internet, grab the bits of information to actually make the PRD. Cool, so it finished. As you can see, it also updated our claude.md file so that it has all of the context for the specific application we're building. Let's take a look at the PRD and see what it created. As you can see, it created a pretty thorough PRD, listing out the technology stack, the core functionality, what it should and should not do, for example, non-requirements. It also talks about usage, success criteria, and actually even future considerations as we think about where our application could go once we get it working. Now, going a step further, in a real world, you wouldn't just give a software engineer a 100-page PRD. You would break that down into logical chunks or steps for them to go complete. And we want to do that exact same thing here. I have a second prompt that I'm going to send into Claude, and I'm going to ask it to take the PRD and make logical chunks that we can then send into Claude Code to fully build out our application. In my prompt, I'm also asking it to use the Claude Prompt Engineering best practices that I got from their website. I will copy-paste this into the terminal window, and it will create a file with all of the code chunks. Awesome, so it completed that step. Let's now go review the build commands that it created. So it actually created exactly what I wanted, right? It used the best practice of using XML tags that Claude recommends. And as you can see, it made a prompt object. Within that prompt object, it has a role, content, as well as instructions. This will provide Claude Code exactly what it needs to fully build out our application. And the next step is simply to copy-paste in each of these different commands into the terminal window, allowing it to step-by-step make our application. I'm going to go ahead and do that now and come back once I've completed building the application. Before getting to the very end, I do want to note I've completed the first step, and as you can see, it actually lists out everything that it did. And a best practice is, as you're completing these steps, going and making sure that it did actually do what you're asking it to. And in this one, I'm asking it to do several things related to just setting up the actual repository. And as we can see, it did in fact do those different things. So I'm going to continue on with command 2. All right, so it actually completed. I went through all commands, there were 6 of them, and the last one was creating some sample data and creating a README. So let's go check out the README and see what we need to do to run this application. Looking at the README, this is actually really detailed, and it even includes information I didn't expect. Scrolling down, it has information on actually setting up a client credentials application, which is something I said to go look at the documentation earlier. It includes that. It talks about creating a DocGen template, even includes information on how to generate a document. So the first thing it says we need to do is copy the ENV file, add in our environment variables, and after that, we should be able to run it. So I'm going to do that real fast, and I'll be right back. So I filled out an ENV file, set up a virtual environment, and installed the third-party libraries as described in the README. So let's run this command and see if the application works. Again, I'm expecting it to use some JSON data that our code samples created, and it should create a file named customer contract. I see some logging here. All these logs look great. It looks like the document's created. Let's go over to Box and see. I'm going to refresh this page. Awesome. Our generated contract is in fact here, and we can see the data that I input is in fact utilized in the document. This is so cool. Claude Code sped up my time to production, and I didn't really need to know much about the Box API. I gave it links to a few pieces of documentation, but that's really it. The power of Claude Code is that I did this in like 30 minutes, maybe an hour, whereas it would have taken me several days probably to actually implement a full solution like this. And I know one question you probably have is, how much did this cost? Looking at the Claude console, it only cost me about $3. That's crazy. I coded a full application just by creating very specific prompts. That's saving a lot of time and money.